Today we will be talking about MeshBaker tools for adding objects. Most of these tutorial demo scenes are simple enough that we can just drag the source objects we want into the MeshBaker components. What do we do if we have a complex scene with many different objects, like you would find in a real project? Tools for adding objects makes it simple to search through your scene for groups of objects to be added to any MeshBaker or TextureBaker components. This is a separate window you can keep open in your editor. It can be opened from the Window menu or by clicking on the Tools for Adding Objects on any of the baking components. There are two tabs in this tool: Analyze Scene and Generate Bakers, and Search for Meshes to Add, which is where we'll start. This tab contains many filters that allow us to quickly select objects in the scene that meet certain criteria. For example, we can quickly add all static objects that use a certain material or shader. Just select a group of objects in your scene, set your filters, and click Add Selected Meshes to Target. This tab works with a mesh baker, texture baker, or multi-mesh baker. It has a field which tells you which baker component you're currently adding objects to. This field will default to whichever component you open the tool from. However, if we dock this somewhere in our editor, we can drag a different component into this field and start adding objects to that instead. Select one or more game objects in your scene. The search will apply to selected objects and their children. These other fields filter your selection so that only objects that meet these criteria are added to your component. For example, I could add all the objects that are children of the environment and props game objects that use a certain vegetation material and use a custom mosh shader. I could filter these further by static objects only, or by objects that match a certain naming pattern. Any combination of these filters can be used. Then just click Add Meshes to Target. Now look at the information panel. It tells us how many objects were added. It also shows how many objects were rejected and why they were rejected. We can see that zero objects were added because none were found using the right shader, so let's adjust our filter to remove that requirement and add those objects again. This time, 84 objects were added. Now let's move on to the other tab, Analyze Scene and Generate Bakers. This is an extremely powerful tool for grouping objects in your scene based on group by filters. If we push List Shaders in Scene, we see a list of groups based on the current filters. A mesh baker can be created for each grouping that it finds. Each of these dropdowns acts as a filter, with priority starting at the top and moving towards the bottom. You could use a simple case, like setting the top filter to material and the rest to none. The report will show a group for each material in your scene, similar to if you used the material filter in the Search for Meshes to Add tab. A more complex example, we could group first by static or dynamic, then by shader, then by lightmap index. If you pick an output folder for your combined objects, clicking the Generate Baker button will create a texture baker with an attached mesh baker grouper, with all of the objects in the group already added. You can also check this box at the bottom, which will split up large groups whose textures would not all fit in a combined texture, saving you another step of separating these into separate texture bakers. To see more examples of these tools in action, check out some of our workflow tutorials where we optimize realistic game scenes step by step. MeshBaker is available on the Unity Asset Store, or you can visit us at digitalopus.ca for more tips and resources for using MeshBaker.